The Qinghai-Tibet Railway was the first railway to reach the hinterland of Tibet. It is the world's highest and longest plateau railway. With a total length of 1,956 kilometers, the railroad was built by joining two sections together. The first section starts from Xining and ends in Golmud, two cities in Qinghai province. The second section starts from Golmud and ends in Lhasa, Tibet. If traveling to Lhasa by train, you will discover that the most important part of the rail, the Golmud-Lhasa section, is a single-track railway instead of a double-track or multi-track one. But why? Why does the Qinghai-Tibet Railway only have one track? Let's start with the construction of the railway. The underdeveloped traffic infrastructure on the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau seriously restricted the local economic growth. When the People's Republic of China was established in 1949, the entirety of Tibet had only 1 kilometer of road for automobile travel. American travel writer Paul Theroux wrote in Riding the Iron Rooster that because of the Kunlun Mountains, trains would never be able to reach Lhasa. In the 1950s, the Central Committee of the Communist Party of China decided to connect Lhasa with other parts of China. In 1984, after 30 years of surveys and construction, the Xining-Golmud section of the Qinghai-Tibet Railway was completed. At that time, this section was also single track. In 2001, the construction of the second section, the Golmud-Lhasa section, was initiated. And in 2006, the two sections were joined together and put into operation. The whole construction lasted for half a century. To build such a railway that reaches Tibet was a long-held wish of generations of railway engineers and Tibetan people. In order to make this once impossible dream come true, they overcame difficulties and obstructs beyond imagination. The elevation of the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau is generally between 3,000 and 5,000 meters. There was no experience of building railways at such a height anywhere in the world. Chinese scientists and construction teams had to find solutions to problems such as frozen soil, lack of oxygen, extreme cold, and ecological fragility. The investment for the Golmud-Lhasa section, which has only one track, was 33 billion RMB. Building a double-track rail could certainly increase the transportation capacity, but at the same time, it would have required huge additional expenditure, which made it economically unviable. Though the Qinghai-Tibet Railway accounts for the transportation of 3/4 of Tibet's goods and materials, it still has much unused capacity. Given this, constructing a double-track rail would have been a waste of resources and equipment and greatly increased the difficulty of railway maintenance. Rich in flora and fauna, the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau's ecological environment is fragile. Once the ecosystem is damaged, it'll be difficult to recover in a short time. 2 billion RMB was put into a fund for the ecological protection of the region. Demanding regulations regarding ecological protection of the region were also put in place. The single-track railroad takes up less space than a double-track railway would have, thus having less impact on the environment. But what if two trains coming from different directions meet, or one is overtaking another? Though a single-track rail cannot allow two trains to run side by side, a large number of stations and byroads were designed along the way, where one train can make a stop and wait for another to pass. With the development of Western China, will the Qinghai-Tibet Railway gradually become insufficient in terms of its transport capability? This issue was taken into consideration at the very beginning of the railway design. Firstly, reserved passing sidings along the rail can improve the efficiency of passing and overtaking. Additionally, the electrification of the Golmud-Lhasa section, which is estimated to be completed after 2025, will greatly increase the railway's transport capability too. In 2007, the Xining-Golmud section was reconstructed as a double-track railway, and the reconstruction was finished in 2011. The Qinghai-Tibet Railway is of great significance for Tibet's economic development. It promotes Tibet's tourism, which is one of the local pillar industries. In the old days, there was a saying among Chinese travelers, going to Tibet is even harder than traveling abroad. Since the railway was built, tourists have been able to enjoy the scenery on the train and gradually adapt themselves to the plateau's high altitude, mitigating altitude sickness. In 2018, Tibet saw about 34 million visitors, and its annual tourism revenue was 49 billion RMB. Now the wealth of experience gleaned from building the Qinghai-Tibet Railway has been put into use in the construction of the Sichuan-Tibet Railway, which is currently in full swing, an increasing number of tourists are coming to Tibet by train, bringing much-needed money to the historically impoverished region.